Cheers to episode 2 of me recreating looks from RuPaul's Drag Race season 13. However, you may be saying, Ian, the season's almost over and you're barely on episode 2, barely doing your second look. And to that I say, okay, and what about it? What the f*** do you want me to do then? You want me to go back in time and be more organized? You want me to like commit to something like making a video every 2 weeks and actually deliver to it? Well, f*** out of here, because that's not what I do. Anyway, today we're doing Utica's look. Utica's ball challenge sleeping bag couture look. I'm fully clothed and ready to go. So here's some B-roll footage of me stopping by Oakland's Temescal neighborhood for some ice cream before heading to the secondhand store. This place is huge. Okay, so there's a lot of selection of sleeping bags at this thrift store. I just don't know what color to choose. I'm gonna need two. Materials wise, I'll need two, and color blocking wise, two would be good. But we have dark orange slash a burgundy, blue, dark gray, black, another black, dark green, a darker blue. Okay, so I realized that thrift stores offer affordable items such as sleeping bags for people who need them, people who may be homeless. And so I wanted these sleeping bags just to do the thrift store challenge, but to replace these ones that I've just bought from the thrift store, I'm going to just pick up some at Target and donate them to the same exact shelter to quote unquote offset the ones that I just took. And so now for my personal measurements, I needed my waist, the length of my chest, my shoulder armhole, and my neck hole. So what I did here is take a bodice block that I just got from the internet and kind of inserted all my measurements into the measurements that the block had. So my shoulder to the block's shoulder, my neck to the block's neck, my waist to the block's waists, etc. And I remade the bodice block in my dimensions, just using it as a reference. I was just estimating for a lot of this because I knew that the next step I put it on the mannequin and have a more accurate feel of the of how it. And that, oh God, I cannot talk. Okay, so the thing is, it's too tight. The dress form isn't like my size specifically. It's not my size perfectly. The front has a lot of these foldovers that are not good, but I just think that on the sleeping bag fabric, it'll be okay. So right now I'm just marking the cutouts of Utica's body, yaddy yaddy, making sure that I get the middle piece, the two side pieces. Each piece is a different fabric, a different color. I transferred those cutouts to paper and then I transferred them to the scrap fabric. You cannot say scrap fabric quickly like 5 times. Scrap fabric. I cannot do it.
I have it just about at my height, and honestly, this little flap at the bottom, it might be just enough to hide my baby. But we have this double triangle shape hourglass that really accentuates the curls. Maybe I'll use black for the sides, the color for the top. I'm literally just falling into a split right now. I wanna say the front is complete. Now we just gotta work on the train.
So at this point, I'm just planning on how I want my back bodice to go so that I can have that train attached. I want it to be a cute little 6 foot moment. And so I think that this pattern piece would work. I'm gonna cut it out on some paper and then see how it looks on the mannequin. So call me cheap or call me unprepared, but I just pasted a bunch of printer paper together to make this huge back bodice instead of buying actual pattern paper. Anyway, I copied the diagram and I'm marking which piece should be black and which piece should be red so that I can have that cute like color blocking moment that she has in her picture. All right, so after sewing that together, the mock-up is kind of done and I'm thinking that it looks acceptable. It looks about right. The back is a bit tight, but we can work on that.
Here we go. So we got the back center. You can cut two of these or cut on the fold. The inner part will be black, outer part will be red. Then we have our side front, cut two, and our middle front. Cutting on the fold, it'll be red. And don't mind the bachelor, you go Serena P. She did the right thing. Honestly, f*** man, James.
We hope we win. That's what I was. So it's a really great thing for your buck.
Yeah, but we need the deep fryer.
Please, this is happening. I feel like a schoolgirl.
Me too.
Done.
There's a zaddy long legs on my sleeping bag.
So I'm just gonna let them be. Stay out of my way and I'll stay out of yours. So at this point, I'm cutting the insulation from the edges of each sleeping bag piece. This is because each sleeping bag piece is a layer of fabric, a layer of insulation in the middle, and a layer of fabric at the bottom. I'm cutting the insulation from the edges only so that I can sew the two layers of the sleeping bag together without going through the insulation and maybe messing up the machine. After sewing the top and bottom of each individual piece together, I'm sewing all of the individual pieces to each other to make the back bodice. Of course, gonna add a zipper down the back way longer, but all in time. So the dress is done. The main of the dress, it's done. But the thing is, I'm moving out. There's no space in my cart. Absolutely no space. Trust me, this isn't gonna work. I'm gonna throw it away. I'm gonna start again. This time, before making the dress, I need to take out all of the insulation. I can't believe I didn't do that before. Utica definitely took out the insulation. This shit is heavy. Utica took out the insulation. I'm gonna remake the entire dress. My pattern was a little off too. Okay, panic. Okay, so at this point in the video, I'm literally moving from Northern California to Texas, my parents' house. But I'm just deciding, what the hell? I'll just vlog the journey. Wait, did I say blog? I meant vlog. See that? Is that an anemone? Is it an anemone?
Sea snakes?
No, okay, I was like, what?
There it is.
Oh, I hate it. It's so scary.
Oh, what is the octopus? They're all connected.
They're all connected?
It is a head.
Okay, where's the head? Is that round thingish? Oh, it's gonna get eaten! Oh, they're biting! No! It's like a baby. So would it be like a complete sham if I literally just used Utica's one? Why don't they make adult sleeping bags this cute as hell? Like, I would absolutely be sleeping in a f***ing unicorn bag. So it's been about 3 weeks since I've done any work, any progress on the garment. Basically, I'm starting it all over again, fixing the pattern and taking out all the insulation. Hopefully this time lapse will have ended by the time I get to the self-checkout line. And this is what it kind of looks like. After making the cuts, I had to decide what color blocking scheme to go with. This was so hard, but after consulting three friends and not listening to any of them, I went with this. I'm gonna finish the hems. I'll figure out how to finish them, put in some beading or something cute along the hems, because I'm not going to just hem it. Okay, ladies and gents and everyone in between, all we have left is the shoulder. So here's the shoulder piece, and then here's what it looks like with the shoulder on. She's done! Low-key, I want her to be bigger! So we're gonna add the last remaining patch of our fabric to the pink train here. And there. I might buy one more gray and red sleeving bag for this, just to make it
extra long.
People can do hard things.
Okay, folks, I think it's done. Gonna grab my friend TJ, go to some random place to film this, and wrap up what should have been a 1 week process, but took 4 weeks.
Ryan Little.
If you've made it this far, thank you so much for watching the video. So please like, subscribe, and comment. Also, let me know if there's any other looks from the season that I should recreate. Because this look was hard to recreate. It was hard. I'm not gonna lie. It was so hard. I made like 3 versions of it. Anyway, thank you for tuning in, and I'll see you next time.